talking to him. He talking to him. You see this man right here? The 12 tribes of Israel. You see this same talking to the people on his side. He said, oh, Israel, not talking about their country over there. He said, happy are we, Reed, for things that are pleasing to God are made known unto us. So the things that pleasing to God are made known to our people. Because the Most High ain't dealing with nobody but us. Give me Psalms 147, verse 19. I want to ask you something. God gave us some names on the left-hand side. The slave master gave you these names on the right-hand side. What family on earth do you belong to according to this sign? Yeah, what family on earth do you belong to according to this sign? The tribe of Judah. The tribe of Judah. And that's what we have to do to show our people who they are. But we had another nation of people teaching us who we were. For 300 years, they restricted you from reading and writing, gave you that damn devil right there, told you was a nigga and an African American, told you that you was a Gentile, and told you that you was nothing. But now today you heard that you from the tribe of Judah. That you God chose the people, and God loves you and all of you.
That's so, right,
man. Let me show you. It say, happy are we, O Israel, because we know what's pleasing to God. Listen to this, read. The book of Psalms, chapter 147, verse 19. He showed his word unto Jacob. The Most High showed his word unto Jacob. Jacob's name was changed to the, Israel. We are the children of Israel.
That's
God
right.
chose the people.
That's
the
right.
greatest nation on the planet Earth.
That's right,
now,
right.
We are in captivity. Right now, we are oppressed and being afflicted. He said, read that again. He showed his word unto Jacob. The Most High showed his word unto us. Why? So we can know what to do to live and know what to do to avoid punishment. So we can know what's pleasing to God. Read on. His statutes and his judgment unto Israel. He has not dealt so. Listen to this. It says the Most High ain't dealt so, Reed. He has not dealt so with any nation. Now have you heard that in church? They tell you God loves everybody, don't they? They tell you God is the God. As a matter of fact, they go to John 3:16, don't they? Get John 3:16. Because John 3:16 might be in your head right now, right? You thinking about John 3. Hey, yeah, you know, see? Yeah, hey, see? See? Now look. See, look, our people know everybody know John 3:16. But you didn't know that what was pleasing to God. You didn't know that you was from the tribe of Judah. So let's go to John 3:16. Right now, read the book of John, chapter 3, verse 16. For God so loved the world. God so loved the world. Our people love this verse. God so loved the world, read, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish. So that's talking about everybody, right? That's talking about everybody, right? Let me tell you something real quick, Nelson. Go Psalms 1:10 real quick. Now look, we're going to start at verse 14. I'm going to show you something, because when you know a little something about the Bible and else, I'll check this out. I'm going to show you something. First, let's read through real quick.
The book of Psalms, 111 and verse 10. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
God said the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, read.
A good understanding have all they that do his commandments.
So to get the understanding of John 3:16, first of all, you got to fear the Lord. Second of all, you got to start to keep the commandments. Now go to Proverbs 8, verse 13. I'm going to show you what it means to fear the Lord. I'm going to let the next brother come up in a minute. Now listen to this, brother.
Proverbs chapter 8 and verse 13.
Now listen to this, Nelson. This is what it means to fear God.
The fear of the Lord is to hate evil.
The fear of the Lord is to hate evil. So guess what? We got to keep the command. The Most High told us that eat pork is abomination. That's evil. A man cutting the spirit off his slave. That's evil. You know what I'm saying? Breaking his Sabbath day. That's evil. Keeping the holidays that ain't in the Bible. That's evil. The fear of the Lord is to hate evil, read.
Pride and arrogancy and the evil way. And the foreign mouth do I hate.
But God said he hates pride and arrogance. People that don't like to learn. He said he hates that right there. Because now people know, just like they quote the scripture, Let's go back to the scripture. Let's start at verse 14. Then that's the next brother come up. Read it, brother. John 3, verse 14. Now listen to this.
The book of John, chapter 3 and verse 14. The book of John, chapter 3 and verse 14. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up.
So you hear that? It says, so as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up. Now I'm going to ask you this, Nelson. Who did Moses lift up the serpent in the wilderness to? You remember what happened in the wilderness? When those snakes was biting the children of Israel? And what Moses do? The Most High told him to make a symbol of a snake, right? And say, everybody that look upon it gonna be saved, right? Okay, now look, that happened to who? The children of Israel. All the children of Israel that looked upon that snake was healed because the snake was biting them because they was in sin. So he told them, let the snake and look at it and you gonna be healed. So read that one more time.
And as Moses looked up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up.
So he said, the same way that Moses lifted up that serpent in the wilderness for the children of Israel, the same way must the Son of Man, or Christ, be lifted up to save the children of Israel. Read.
Now whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life.
It said, read it again. He said he got the picture of it. Now read it again.
Now whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life.
Then whosoever believeth in him will not perish, but have eternal life. Now let me show you about the serpent being lifted up in the wilderness. Numbers 21, verse 9, read.
Numbers chapter 21 and verse 9. And Moses made a serpent of brass and put it upon a pole. And it came to pass that if a serpent had bitten any man, when he beheld the serpent of brass, he lived.
So you see that? Now we're showing you the history about that. Now jump up to verse 7.
Verse 7. Therefore, the people came to Moses and said, we have sinned.
Because we sinned against the Most High God. That's why he sent those fiery serpents against us. Now go back to John 3, verse 14.
The book of John, chapter 3, and verse 14.
Bring it out.
And as Moses looked up the serpent in the wilderness.
So who he lifted up that serpent in the wilderness to? We just read it right there. The children of Israel. And it said everybody that looked upon him was going to be what? Gonna be healed, gonna be saved, read.
Even so must the Son of Man be lifted up.
The Son of Man gotta be lifted up the same way that brass serpent was lifted up. Yes. Why? The same who? The same who, Nelson? To save us, the children of Israel. Read it up.
That whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life.
Now read on.
4 John chapter 3 and verse 16. For God so loved the world.
So hold on, it's plenty meaning for the word world. When they found the Americans, what did they call it? They called it the new world. When they found the Americans, they called it the new world. That's one meaning, a particular part of the earth. What's another meaning for the word world? A class, a society of people. What's another meaning for the word world? You got the animal world. You got the sea world. You know what I'm saying? You got all different types of worlds. So what world is God talking about? Isaiah 45, verse 17.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 45, and verse 17. But Israel shall be saved in the Lord with an everlasting salvation.
Who gonna be saved, Nelson? Read that again.
But Israel.
Who gonna be saved? I read.
But Israel shall be saved in the Lord with an everlasting salvation.
How long that salvation gonna be, Nelson? Everlasting.
That's right.
Like that, bro, we suffer. But look, we're going to come up out of this and we ain't going to have to suffer no more. Our salvation is going to be everlasting, read.
Ye shall not be ashamed.
He's saying we shouldn't be ashamed. We shouldn't be ashamed that God loves you, God chose you, and you got everlasting salvation coming, read.
Nor confounded.
Don't be confused neither, because this word is for you, read.
World without end.
What did the Most High just call the children of Israel? What? Let's read it again from the top.
But Israel shall be saved in the Lord with an everlasting salvation. Ye shall not be ashamed nor confounded. World without end.
What did God just call the children of Israel? What? World without
end. That's right.
End.
That's
praise.
Right.
See,
that's
now right. Give him a clap, y'all. He didn't understand. I'll pray for you. See, that's the point we're supposed to give our people to see. give them understanding. God just called the children of Israel to work. Now let's go back to here, read.
John chapter 3 and verse 16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son.
So who is the world? Israel. Hey, hold on, hold on. Let's keep going. I'll pray. See, I'll pray to see Nelson the most. I had you right here for a week.
That's right.
Lord will, you be down here with us next time. You be bringing out the word with this mic. Now, we got brothers down here in St. Louis that you need to link up with. Now, listen.
For God so loved the world.
Of Israel. Because we the world without him. Because that's who everlasting salvation for, we.
That he gave his only begotten son.
Really?
That whosoever believed in him.
Hold on. Whosoever, right? It's everybody, man, no way. If you think y'all see me tonight. All right, now look. Let's get you back on point. Now listen to this.
Acts chapter 2 and verse 21. And it shall come to pass that whosoever.
If whosoever, read.
Shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Read.
Ye men of Israel!
You who?
Ye men of Israel!
We have a word!
Ye men of Israel! Hear these words!
Read it! Hear that? That! Who is talking about that? The whole Bible is talking about you!
That's
the whole Bible is talking about us!
That's
salvation is only for the children of Israel!
That's right!
Let's do 1 verse 21.
Hello!
I want y'all brothers to stand with me, and I'm going to bring up the next brother. Listen.
Matthew chapter 1 and verse 21. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins.
Jesus is going to save his people from their sins. Let's do it together now. Read.
Matthew chapter 1 and verse 21. And she shall bring forth a son.
Brothers, and she,
shall bring forth a son.
Read.
And thou shalt call his name Jesus. For he shall save his people from their sins.
For he shall save his people from their sins.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC. To stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.